Hello and thank you. I'm Andrei Panko and I will be doing demos for you today. In this release, we continue our investment into warehouse and inventory management, and we also added a number of features. Some were added by internal R&D team, but we also received a lot of valuable contributions from the community. You can find all the details in the release notes. It also contains screenshots. But in this session, I will focus on one, or actually number of scenarios around reservation. And we will try to find answers on questions. How you, as a user, can find the answer? What is the status of an existing demand document? Where demand document can be sales order or production consumption or assembly order or jobs and so on. And once you figured out that this document is ready for shipment or for consumption, how to move it to the next stage and start processing, maybe even in automatic mode without your involvement. And because these two will be very much dependent on the reservation status, then the next question or how to do reservations in the most efficient way. Let's see. Let's start with exploring how you do this in a classical way. So for example, you create sales order and we click new and pick our favorite customer, which will be, of course, a Datum Corporation and some item. I created special items to demonstrate that this is a bold way of doing things. All right, let's pick some quantity. The next field, which is important to populate for processing, will be date. So it will be either requested delivery date, if your customer knows when they want things to be available. For example, if it's part of the bigger project like construction or building something huge and they need stuff in the delivered in specific time, or they don't care, but they would like to ask like as soon as possible. And in this case, you can use our already available order promising functionality. For example, let's choose a capable to promise and let system to calculate when things will be available if we will place order right now. Okay, in a couple of weeks. Accept. And now the only thing is to wait. Yeah, wait till date comes and then you need to check. If customer calls you and asks like what is the status, then you need to find the document, and in some situations you can explore the reservation. Okay, there is no hope. This request is still in form of requisition line, so nobody actually submitted to vendor. Not good. Too many clicks, especially if there are so many lines. So what can we do better? First of all, the good indicator that something can be really shipped or used if it is already available in stock, in warehouse. So why not to check it? And if you have things already reserved, then we added a new field which shows reserved from stock. In a very simple way, it has three options. None, nothing is reserved from stock. Partial, if some quantity is reserved from stock, others are either not reserved at all or are reserved from a different source. For example, from production output and they still need to be produced. Or fully, if this is also an option, if everything is available, reserved, and it means you can just go and do. So this is per line. If you have multiple lines, probably you would like to understand the overall situation. In this case, we added this control also in the statistic pages of the different documents. We will take a look at it in details later. So reserve from stock relating to the whole document. Like, okay, in this specific document, nothing to be shipped because nothing is available. Okay, so in some replenishment mechanism, reservation created automatically. What it is? Assembly to order, which are automatically reserved, capable to promise, which creates a supply linked to this demand and reserved for it. Also, you can do it if a planning mechanism is order, or in some cases, you can activate reservation like manually. But what if you're using a lot-for-lot planning policy, or if you prefer to deal with the reorder points replenishment mechanism, then reservation is not there. You need to reserve manually. And this might be a not that easy task. Not anymore. With a new page, which is called Reservation Worksheet, You can do it in dramatically less number of clicks. Let's start by choosing Get Demand Action. And in this request page, we will ignore it for now and press OK. And what do we see here? We see that system actually gathered different demand. It can be sales, transfer, job, assembly, production orders. And all of them need to be reserved. But also, they have items which are both available on stock and not reserved for something else. So like, okay, this is a good situation. Let me change sorting. And let's start processing. How do we do that? We put 7 here, then we, no, of course not, we are not doing it one by one. We have probably a couple of actions to automate this process. Let's press allocate button. And what happened? Magic. Yeah, so multiple lines were received recommended quantity to reserved. System decided to do it in a safe way. You can see that, you can see, for example, for this line, we have a lot available and we have very limited demand. So like 100% can be covered. Yeah. In this case, system allocates stuff. It also does it full allocation if a quantity is enough, even if there are multiple demands. But what if a quantity is not enough for one, or if it doesn't know how to allocate available quantity among different supplies, is skip. But let's go and take a look in the allocation policies. Basically, it's not only option, like this is a basic one, which is run by default, and it executes the safest allocation. You can also add additional one, which is in this case is equally. And guess what? It equally distributes things. You can combine multiple stuff. Today it's only two. We plan to add more. You can also add more allocation rules, which better fits your company processes and rules. All right, let's run it again. And we can see that now all 10 allocated, even if we needed 12. And here, for these four demands, we received 15 quantity each for each line. That looks equal enough. Okay, but before we move forward and actually do reservation, let me show you batches. In some companies, more than one person is doing allocation and they have different preferences. So let's take a look at the batch, which is not that simple. It has additional settings available. For example, you can apply different filters and focus on specific type of demand. Somebody prefers to do allocation only for production orders because they are responsible for this area. Others, sales orders. Or maybe you don't want to system to suggest reservation for some orders or some demand in the future. Like, okay, you have order with a due date in 12 months. Maybe it's not a good idea to reserve it right now. So you can put some period, like starting and end date, instructing which documents should be included into the reservation. Also, you can focus on items. We have a cool filter capability, which allows you to filter not only by number, but basically by any field you can have in the item table, including custom fields. So with the same mechanism we have in the demand forecast today. Plus location, somebody responsible per specific location. Also, you can define different allocation policies and their combinations for batches. Okay, let's select this one and go home, get demand. And in this case, I will, first of all, I will show you that filters are copied from the batch. Okay. And I will activate allocate after populate toggle, which will do clicking instead of me. So I just need to run the stuff and my location, my items are proposed. And you can see that system already allocated as much as possible, including equal allocation of partially available items. Okay. We also use accept toggle when we deal with reservations. So let's select these four lines and mark them as also accepted because we would like to apply this change and click make reservation. You can also decide if you want to apply reservation for specific document type. I will go and continue with all. All right, click OK. Everything is reserved. That was a long story, but a very efficient way in reality to reserve things from the stock. This is very important information from the stock. All right, how can we use this information right now? Of course, statistics is updated. We will take it later, but let's start with something which was part of the product for a long time, but now we can take a look at this report again. So we are interested in sales lines on yellow location. And let's take a preview. Probably makes sense to zoom a little bit and scroll down. Okay, so I have my very special items, which is called reserved, fully, partially, or not reserved. And you can see it has a different status. How it is available, how it is reserved. And system shows the information. So if you are not using any advanced functionality, you can use this report to update quantity in order lines, like the same way as it was possible before, but now with a reservation available. If you use more advanced techniques, for example, you prefer to use warehouse shipments, in this case, we added a special report which has two purposes. Purpose number one, it can use filters. For example, let's pick a full option for reserve from stock filter option. What does it mean? It will create warehouse shipments for yellow locations, but only include lines which are completely reserved. Let's click OK. And let's go and explore created warehouse shipments. Okay, I have two of those. And this one has fully reserved item. And the second also has fully reserved item only. Even if we remember that the second order contained three lines originally, including partially and not reserved item. So this is like option number one to automate. So you can push warehouse receipts for processing to warehouse team directly. So no need to actually go and analyze each sales document individually. The same functionality, kind of the same functionality, also available in the basic warehouse when we talk about inventory picks. I will select inventory pick, reserve from stock full and partial, and filter by location yellow. Some might be curious how I'm going to use and warehouse receipts and inventory picks from the same location. This is also something which changes in this version. Let me click OK. And inventory picks were created. Let's open them and explore. Okay, in this case, I have picks for jobs, and this is a fully reserved. Let's scroll to the next one. This one is fully and partially reserved. And if I will go to original source document, for example, to job card, I can check, first of all, statistics. Yeah. In general, the document is partially available because some lines are fully, some lines are partially. Let's take a look. And some lines are not reserved at all. What about quantity? Yeah, quantity reserved, you can see. Looks different. Okay. Let's go back to very basic scenarios when you do not use warehouse handling, for example, for consumption. Let's go to consumption journal, which is part of manufacturing model, and calculate consumption. And we can also have the same filter here. For example, we will focus on full reservation status. Let's click OK, and we will get two lines. If I will drill down to the list of components in this specific order, you will see, yeah, we have three components, but only one, accordingly to its name, is fully reserved. All right, we can go also to the order, and let me demonstrate you my favorite feature from a client added into this release, show details. Let's open the order, and we can also take a look at the statistics here. Again, reserved from stock, partial. Added into multiple places. So you can check the reservation status basically on any document. So what we figured it out. So now you can check status of the demand document based on its reservation status. much easier. You just check the statistic page. But you don't need to do it in reality because you can configure your system to run some task into background via job queue and push documents to the next stage. For example, create warehouse shipments or create inventory pick, or even to do update quantity to ship or quantity to consume in documents. And because both of them are based on reservation, we figured out how to use a reservation worksheet to do reservations in a very efficient way. As I mentioned during demonstration, I'm using yellow location for different kind of warehouse handling. If you want to know more, take a look at what's new in warehouse management. And if you're already interested in warehouse handling, it makes sense to check another session where we're demonstrating new barcode scanning capabilities on mobile device. Also, I would like to mention different resources, and let's start by submit your idea. Even if it looks like one directional, because it has one directional arrow, votes placed there and ideas really matters. We have a more chatty conversation in a different forum. It's called Yammer. The first link on the left. Please also join, and then you can participate in the design decisions, discussions, and impact on what and how is implemented for the product, and get also early information upfront. Many resources, the all valuable links are links available here if you use this link, BC all. Thank you, and let's stay in touch.